the brain is sort of is trying to decide what a color is based on the light that's coming off of an object, and that will change depending on the colors of lights that are falling on it. So the brain subtracts the light that's falling on it and calculates what's the true color of the object below. And this photograph is, and we all do that a little bit differently in our brain. We do that calculation a little bit differently. And so in this photograph happens to sit, the color balance happens to sit at a region that is very close to, that some people subtract a little more yellow and make it look very deep blue, and other people, their brain subtracts a little less yellow and it looks more golden white. And it just turns out lots of people have slightly different color perceptions about certain colors under certain illuminance, but this one is a much more striking example than I've ever seen, and then apparently as some of my colleagues in the literature have also ever seen it. So this photograph really makes that distinction very, very visible.
It's such a
strong effect, and it's so surprising that people, I mean, you can't believe that anyone could possibly see the world that differently from themselves. I think that's the real interest. I mean, that's my interest in vision, is ultimately was those sort of childhood or perhaps teenager questions of, you know, is the color that I see the same as the color that you see? And here's an example where that's clearly not true. I'm convinced it's sort of a pale blue and a gold, and the resident who saw it otherwise thought it was clearly convinced that we were all crazy and that it was, you know, black and blue.